Bethlehem just over 2,000 years ago, Jacob, Isaac and Samuel were watching their sheep.
87, 88, 89, oh dear, counting sheep always makes me so sleepy. It's because they all look the same and they don't keep still.
It's cold today, isn't it? Do you think it will rain later?
Things continued like this almost all the time. The sheep wandered about. The shepherds counted them. Jacob and Isaac chattered away, and Samuel, well, he didn't say much.
The shepherds lived up on the hills with their sheep. They didn't have cozy houses or warm beds, and one of them had to be awake all the time to make sure the sheep were safe.
It really was a full-time job. The shepherds couldn't always go down to the synagogue to pray or do all the other things the people there to worship God. This meant when they did go down to the town, they weren't always very friendly.
Good morning, Mr. Brown.
Oh, good morning. How are the sheep?
Very well, Mr. Brown, very well.
Good morning, Mr. and Mrs. Green.
Oh, good morning. How are the sheep?
Very well, Mr. and Mrs. Green, very well.
Good morning, Mrs. White.
Oh, good morning, how sheep?
Wow, are you the shepherds? Can I come see the sheep with you one day? Isn't she sleeping in the hills all the time? Do you have to come to us for tea?
Don't want the men now, Benjamin. There's a good boy. I'm sure they're very busy.
They don't look busy to me.
But Benjamin, they're not the sort of people you should be talking to.
What do you mean?
Oh dear, how very awkward. Don't talk to the shepherds, my dear. Can't you see they're not our sort?
Don't talk to the shepherds, my dear.
The shepherds felt that no one cared about them. Everyone seemed to think the sheep were more important than the shepherds.
Through summer sun and winter snow, we sit here on the hills. As seasons come and seasons go, we sit here on the hills. We do not hear the village news. We do not join in all their fun. We are not asked to anything. We are not missed by anyone.
Oh, this whole town cares more about
But let's not get ahead of ourselves. In another part of the country, a young woman called Mary was getting some very, from some very unusual visitor.
Man. When he heard Mary's news, he decided they should get married straight away.
Not long after, there was more news announced by some Romans who were living in the land at that time. Caesar Augustus has declared that there will be a census of all people in this land. We need to count how many people live in this country. Husbands, you must go to the town your family comes from, wives, and you must go with them.
This meant that Joseph had to travel all the way to Bethlehem and Mary with him. It was getting very close to the time her baby would be born, and it was a long and tiring journey.
Lots of people had gone back to Bethlehem to be counted, and it was very, very busy for such a small town. People welcomed back their relatives, and soon there wasn't a spare room free in the whole town.
Well, there may have been one or two of them, but some people aren't just prepared to share.
Why can't we have anyone to stay, Ma? Sarah's got 8 cousins sleeping in her house tonight.
Benjamin, these people are exhausted. They've travelled a long way in dusty roads. They're going to be wanting to lie around sleeping, getting my way, and will be hungry now, stories to tell.
I know, it sounds great.
I don't have time for all that nonsense. I have to get ready for the rabbi coming tomorrow.
It was late when Mary and Joseph arrived, and they were very tired. Joseph knocked at the door of the inn.
Hello, can I help you?
We need somewhere to stay for the night, please.
Sorry, sir, we're full.
Please, sir, do you have anything? My wife is going to have a baby soon and is very tired.
What's going on? We don't have any rooms left, you know.
But this lady's going to have a baby. What can we do?
Well, lots of ladies are going to have babies at some time or another, but we still don't have any rooms.
But look, she's huge.
Let me see. Oh, I see. Well, don't just stand there, man. Get there into the stable. It's nice and warm, and I'll come down and see you later on.
Thank you.
around.
And later that night, Mary's baby was born. She named him Jesus and laid him in a manger because there was no bed for him. The baby lying in a manger, just as the angel had said.
God's baby. angel came and told us. The whole sky was filled with the glory of God.
And so the three shepherds sat down with Mary and Joseph, and they all talked about the incredible things which happened to them.
The shepherds enjoyed being welcomed into that special place at that very special time, and Mary and Joseph did not mind that they had not been able to wash or pray in all the special ways that the other people of the town did.
However, it was not long before the sleepy town of Bethlehem was woken by some more visitors, but these visitors were much quite important for them. Exotic smells of spices and perfumes from faraway lands.
A new king has been born. He will be known as the King of Kings, and I will show you the way to him.
And so the wise men had followed the star all the way to Bethlehem, where they stopped above the stable. The wise men went in and knelt before the baby, presenting their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
The procession of wise men with their servants and camels had woken many people in the town who followed them and came to see what was going on.
As many of them as possible crowded in to see what was going on.
Isn't this just wonderful?
It is. We must make sure we tell all our children and grandchildren all about it so that tonight is never forgotten.
Once in royal David's city stood a lonely cattle shed where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mount Jesus Christ, her little child.
He came down to earth from heaven, who is God and Lord of all. And his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall.
To see that the shepherds had got there before them, but most of them were polite about it.
Excuse me, I'm not invited to say Your Grace, Your Highness, or Excellency, or what.
My name is Casper, madam.
Well, excuse me, Sir Casper.
Just Casper, madam.
Really, well, excuse me, Casper, but can you ask a question? I can understand why God would tell three kings and three wise men about the birth of his son, but I don't understand why he told the shepherds of us. I mean, they aren't at all important. They hardly ever come to synagogue, and to be honest, they smell. Why would God tell them first?
Ah, madam, I believe our friend Samuel can explain that to you.
Oh no, you don't understand, he doesn't talk.
But isn't it that your scriptures say, he that restrains his lips is wise? I believe our friend Samuel has been waiting until he has something worth saying. Am I right?
When we look at a tiny baby, little fingers, little toes, it's so easy to remember just how precious our life is. Yet somehow as we grow older, we don't remember. So today, when you meet someone different in the street, or somebody that you know, get right up your nose. Don't go thinking that they're not as good as you. 'Cause deep down inside, you know that is not true.
Because everyone is a miracle. A living, breathing miracle. Look into your eyes, you'll
was that the people of Bethlehem realized that they had been a part of a story of miracles all along.
Jacob, Isaac, and Samuel were treated better by the other people of the town after that night. No one forgot that God thought they were important enough to hear about his son first.
The good news that God was brought was for all people, rich and poor, far and near, knew that God was sending his peace from heaven, his peace to us from heaven.
But today we hear news of different sorts on our TVs and radios. We hear about fights and wars and people treating each other badly. It's hard to believe that the angel brought their message from peace and love.
But the message did come. Remember Samuel's words in his song, "Look into our eyes, you'll find it easier to see the miracle that's you, the miracle that's me."
If we remember that we are all miracles, we will treat each other better, and then we will really see the peace on earth that the angel sang about.
And so we pray this Christmas that you will find peace in your families, in your homes, and in our school.
And may we do our own little bit to spread peace throughout the world. And may we wish you all a very Merry Christmas!
The most wonderful performance. It was just breathtaking. It's been a fantastic day down at the Nippers today. There was the nursery nativity early this morning, and I think I recognise some of the tea towels that have been passing to older siblings. But what a wonderful production, not only because of the acting, the narrating, the singing, the learning of the lines, everything was crystal clear, but in terms of the actual story as well, so wonderful to hear the traditional nativity, but understand also why it's important in the 21st century. That came through very clearly indeed. So many people have been involved with the production. All the early years teachers have been fantastically busy. My thanks also to Simon Lowe, doing all the technical stuff in the box. A number of the senior school teachers have been involved. But what a fantastic effort from Mrs. Coleman, who's not only directed and produced the play this afternoon, but she wrote it as well. And I think she deserves it. Please join me in thanking the cast.
Bible.